What are Fedora website? Fedora website are probably the first place a user getting contact with when searching for Fedora on the web. And for this reason, is very important for the project. Okay. And okay, we maintain this this website domain, alt, arm, boot, budget, Fedora community, Fedora project, talk to Fedora, and so on. So, okay. We communicate on IRC Sunnel, Fedora website on Freenode network, and by mailing list on this URL. And where do you can find the docs on this the link? Okay. And one on pagure.io/fedora-fedora websites is the mailing page on our overview, and wiki page, and docs.pagure.org/fedora-fedora websites on the docs document we are producing. Okay. And how we work on the bug tracking and ticketing on Pagure, Bugzilla, and mailing list and IRC. We open a ticket for us on this system, and we use Git, Bootstrap, Python, mainly HTML/CSS, and the Genshi framework for internationalization. So now you set up your system, and this is the command we can find to the Pagure overview, sudo dnf install git getx, okay, and clone the repo, but not now. We have prepared the USB key because the Wi-Fi network okay is not good. Okay, so we share you this key to copy and paste the directory of the repo. Okay.
I have it downloaded.
Have it done? Oh, perfect. We need this, no?
I need.
Okay, perfect. You find the directory
so, yes.
For our website?
It's been here.
You can copy and paste where
I guess you all have the Git user set up in your system, right? Mm-hmm. Who has not?
I think
no,
I
you
have.
You not?
I think so.
To set up the Git, to use Git, you have to set up your name with the email address. And, okay. So the most important thing is now to install first these packages. These are a few Python packages we need for the internationalization, and then the web server. You can find this on pagure.io. /Fedora website. On the overview, you have the how to start. So you can just copy the command instead of copying it here and writing.
Okay.
Welp needs the repo? All of you, I guess. Who wants the repo? Copy on this CD? Yes?
Launch instance for a test, make and test. You must go in the Fedora website repo directory / subdirectory what you want to build an instance of the test.
Yes, but getfedora.org has an error when you make and test.
Yes.
Yes, getfedora is the website.
So you will find more or less all these websites in the repo as the subdirectories. Get Fedora and Alt Fedora project need an internet connection to build. So because they need data from data grabber, and I'm not sure.
There's JSON error.
Yeah, just repeat it.
For this reason, we have choose spins.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, it takes a while. To build the websites, the server needs about 30 minutes every hour.
Okay.
And when you do that locally, just for one language, forget Fedora, probably it will take a minute or something like that.
Yeah,
it depends on your internet connection.
Yeah, eventually it was the error I've tried before.
Yeah, and when it gets a timeout from data grabber, then it won't find the JSON file,
yeah,
and it will throw out an error. But this looks quite good now. It's looking for the AMIs, because Atomic has a 2-week release cycle,
mm-hmm.
and we always search for the last release, and then based on that we build the path of this release, Atomic release,
mm-hmm.
and Atomic also has the Amazon images. So
yes. Now it's through there.
And again?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's always the same.
Over here.
Same. It's from that image. It's probably better if you use another website. To show the workflow just.
Yes, okay.
So
except
Alt and
spins
is okay,
yeah.
Spins ARM is okay, Labs is okay. It's just Alt, which has AMIs inside, and Get Fedora, which is rather. Yeah.
I'm getting the same JSON error.
Mm, yeah, that depends on the internet connection here.
Mm.
It's rather annoying, yeah. But once you get through it, we cache this JSON file, and it will be kept for about a day or so in your in your PC for the next build. If you need to work on Get Fedora, you can wait always a minute to rebuild the website and see how it looks.
Right.
We cache the JSON file, so you, you will build the website in about 3 or 4 seconds. It's okay.
Okay.
I built the website just so that Get Fedora, I built it this morning, and the output should look like this. We get at the end a localhost 5000 plus last instance.
Okay, sorry.
Oh, no word.
And stop the test instance. You should make a stop test comment. Okay.
So if you work on test instances, you can always choose the language in which you want to build your website. Make English test. If you write just make test, it will get all the languages, will build all the languages. So we have about 70 or 80 languages. It will take rather long. That's why the web server takes about half an hour. And so the best is if you choose the English version, so you won't have translation issues or something like that. We have the translation files, the PO files in the repo, just for testing. So this is not something we build the real website on, because the websites are built from the NATA directory. That's why we choose to make English test.
Okay. And how in every single subdomain directory you can find these three, like the following. For example, spins domain. It makes from data directory, make file, PO directory, it is for the translation, and static, and the directory, mainly directory that we use to make a build of our website is build.d. For build a directory that contains file Python files, okay. And this is the file to create the instance, the local instance for the website. Web3. This is an example, a deeper look for the website tree. Main directory of the website. This is for spins example. Okay. Data directory contains the all HTML pages. Okay.
So data is the directory where the pages are in, the HTML files are in. You will have single HTML files in content. And we use obviously also templates. If we need some pieces in more than one page, we have a template directory, and they are all in the data directory. So we will see the content and templates. These are the two directories which are important if you want to start. Don't care too much about the build process. This is not something you should care about now. Just keep in mind we use a make file to build the websites, otherwise we can't execute the Python scripts we have on the websites repo, and all our websites websites are static websites, so there's nothing dynamic. We don't have a framework. We just build and rebuild the websites every hour. Okay. Any doubts on that? On three.
And on the in the direct contents directory, we find the subdomain. In this case, spins, cinnamon, LXDA, LXQT for the spins of Fedora operating system. Okay. In the subdirectory PO, we find many PO files. The most important file is a source file. Okay. It is the name of the domain .pot and contains all strings of a specific website for the localization teams use on Zanata. Okay.
So we have Alex, which is our Zanata man here. No, we don't do localization. We do internationalization.
The internet zone.
And so we care about the source file, the POT file. We create this file. We can just create this file. When you open the main make file, you will see the instruction, which is a make POT. We can create this source file and push it to Zanata. Translators will grab it on Zanata, or it's just in their language section, or in their language, in their document on Zanata they want to translate. They translate them, and the web server will pull the PO files from Zanata directly. We'll create the MO files to execute them. And that's why any translation issues are not on the website. We can, if we want to, all this process manually. We can also say to the server, you don't use Zanata, but use the repo to build the websites in a specific language. But normally we don't do that. We just fix the problem on Zanata and continue the normal workflow, which is hourly. We pull all the translations hourly.
This is the.
Are there any translators here? Rafael, you probably?
No.
Not really.
Not really.
I'm a member of a translation team, but there's another guy who did all translations already. So
Okay.
I know him, but it's not me who did the translation.
Okay. Ah, yes, you have the, how's his name? The main translator in?
Piotr Drom.
Piotr, yeah.
Yeah, that's him.
Yeah, he's very experienced translator, yes.
Extremely.
Yeah.
Okay. And this is the file IoT. Okay, contains all the strings.
Yes, there are only a few persons who can push that file to Zanata. It's me and the other two guys. So if you need to create a new source file to push to Zanata, you should just ping me and I can do that. But normally, when I see commits with interests, new translation strings, I will do that. I hope I don't forget that. But normally, I remember to push it to Zanata too. Yes. Sometimes Piotr writes me an email and, hey, you didn't push that to Zanata. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, he reports problems within hours.
Yes, right.
Okay. In the build.d directory, we can file the global var files, global var.py. Wait.
If you have this the repo on the PC, you can take a look. This is one of the most important files we have in the
maybe the only important file we have in the build.d directory, and which interests you if you want to work or want to start to work on the website. It's you probably remember all the websites we maintain. There's Labs, Pins, Get Fedora, and so on. Just imagine if we change from Fedora 25 to Fedora 26 and do that manually. This is a work which never ends. So we have a file where we have variables. The 26 and 25 is just a variable which we use on every website. So we just need to change that in the variable file. And this is the global variable Python file. If you open it, or if you want to take a look at it, it's rather...
This is the opening file?
It was rather small when I started. It has become a huge document now. And we have path inside, we have the image sizes, we have...
ISO size.
We had AMIs in the past. AMIs are now created with a separate script. For some specific AMI IDs, we still fill it out in this file. So these are all commented on, not important anymore.
Mm. How do you maintain this file? It looks like
this one.
Is it generated? Or?
No, it's
no?
Manually.
Mm-hmm.
See?
Yes.
Yes. You just change the value of the variable. And if you write a string in the HTML file, you recall the variable directly, and it will take it. So it's not something we can create. It's the source where we create the website from.
Mm-hmm. Everything relates the new Fedora. We must change this prev ID, current ID, and next ID to works on Fedora website the new relays to show on the website.
Yes, we don't have next ID anymore. Mm-hmm. I remember on fedoraproject.org we had. Take a look at Fedora 27, and you will find the documentation there. We don't use that anymore. We have directly IDs per single edition. So we have for Workstation an ID, we have for Atomic an ID, we have for Cloud an ID, because theoretically they could not follow the release cycle. Atomic already doesn't follow the release cycle. Server, who knows what the future will bring.
For example, this banner. This banner is hard-coded
yes,
without the number.
Yeah,
okay.
I was asking mainly because I see that there is a lot of information about sizes, ISO images, and this
yes.
kind of thing.
We could do that with a script, yes. Yes. If you want and have time to, please do it. Yes, we could go to dl.fedoraproject to the main mirror and get it from there, yes. Oh, use FatFind directly.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Okay. And for the internationalization, we use Genshi framework, and the templates needs strings of code. So the example strings. The example strings. The simplest example, only string, that the localization team
the they are translated in your languages. Okay. For the for the use a string and more more complex use the use markup markup the words of the Genshi framework to explain on the framework with the variables. Okay, HTML code to generate the HTML code. Okay, and example using a variable is this always markup. Okay, string. This is the characters to create the symbol minus minus symbol.
Well, the main difference here is we have just four markups, Genshi markups. We don't use the whole Genshi framework to for translations. The packages you installed before are mainly to extract these strings to the POT file we then put to Zenata. The most simple one is just a string. So my name is Robert. There's nothing inside. There's just a text. Or I have 80 years. There's no embed code. If you have an HTML code, if you use strong, for example, if you want to make characters, bold characters, you can do that within the string. You need to use the markup, markup. If you have variables inside, we use that to simplify the work to our translators. It's rather difficult if you have a string with HTML code inside. Probably half of the translators will fail the string, and that will break the translations. So we try to avoid that. Just make a variable inside this one, and we add the. So this variable here is just a link. Getfedora.org. So we use the ampersand characters, the special characters, HTML characters, to build the string and use a variable inside. Translators will just see the variable and can put it where they need to have it in their language. So in Polish probably at the end, or in another language you need a variable more in another position. To make the sentence correct in the localized language. If you want to combine more variables, you need to use this differently. You have, for example, here you have the percentage symbol and just add the link. If you have more than one variable, you need to use the other brackets. You need to open them. The brackets and just put in the variables you want to use. So variable arch, variable size are defined here. Is this understandable or? Yeah, Genshi errors when building websites are very frequent when
yes.
You start to work on it.
Can you explain to me why in this strings with HTML, why do you escape the angle brackets? Why do you need to write the XML escape?
This one?
Yes. Why not just do a bracket?
Here?
No. I mean the LT and GT things.
This one?
Yes. Those are.
This is the
right bracket or the left bracket? Yes.
Yes. The left and the right.
Why
we use the special characters because otherwise Genshi will write it as as text, you need in Python to escape the special characters.
It seems backwards because I think, well, you use GT if you don't want HTML.
You have always to use the emphasized character, the special characters in the stream, because Genji is.
Okay, maybe it's a Genji thing.
Yeah, it's a Genji thing. You can try to do that and build it. And you will get a Genji error, yes.
Mm.
You also need to escape special characters with a slash, with a backslash. For example, if you write it's, you have this et. How do you call it? It has a apostrophe. Yeah. Yes, you need to escape this.
Yes.
Because Genji otherwise will not finish. Most easy thing is at the beginning to look how similar strings are built and then say, okay, my string would look like that. And then try it. And if you don't know any solution, then ping us on IRC. Yeah, I need help.
Which one?
Yeah, I think this would be better. I see the error now, but maybe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not a Genji expert, but I know we use these four kinds of markups and they need to work like that.
So,
I passed days and weeks on that documentation. But it's too much for what we are doing on the website.
Yes. Well, the localization doesn't help things because it doesn't seem like it's compatible with Genji. It's independent.
Mm-hmm.
The translations. So
yes.
It's another layer of complexity.
Yes, and probably within our make file, this doesn't work properly as Genji goes. I don't know if you need to define all the things here. You just say actually Genji that you have to do Genji requires. And I'm not sure if defining this differently, we could use the normal HTML.
There's Whopper.
Yes.
Sorry.
It's for greater than and less than.
Yes. Okay.
Greater and less, yeah.
Yeah. Sorry. Okay. To the search, on the search, this is the simple strings. Okay. To coding these symbols. Okay.
Okay. Do you have questions?
I have a question.
Yeah. Rather not. Probably when working on it, yes.
Okay, now we hands on tickets. Okay. So.
Are you already on Pagir?
I already have my tickets.
You already have your ticket, that's good.
Okay. On Pagir, we have a ticket. That namely easy fix.
Yes, we have some easy fix tickets. I don't know if you have one actually.
Yes.
We have 22 open, 21. I closed one this morning, but okay. some of these are rather easy, others are too complicated for today. Which one do you want to work on? We can.
You can choose.
Which one?
Well, I made an issue like a month ago. Parameterize things in labs in the index pages.
Arm download. Yeah, that's rather easy. Yes. We have another thing to add here. We need to group also labs because we have an arm image for Python classroom now. Which we don't show on the exactly. We have a Python image and we group image. So what you're saying is we group server and desktop on the main page, and on the checksum we group them differently. It's the minimal image, right?
Mm-hmm.
The minimal image is in the desktop checksums.
Okay.
But we group it on the server in the here.
Fedora minimal is
here
in
as minimal, but if you go to verify, validate server, but it should be here the minimal. It's not in server, it's in spins.
Spins.
Click on. It's here. That was the issue, right? So we can't change the files. Because the minimal image is always in the spins, we can probably use a different approach. We can or double the. Can you go back to the verify page?
Yes.
We can double this image and make another one below it.
It's just checksums. Why not just have one file with all of them? It's very small.
One file?
With all of the checksums. Why separate them?
I don't know what you mean. We have three checksums and we can't change them.
Well, why not have just one?
One checksum with all in it?
Yes.
Yes. So checksums are done by engineering, they are signed, and we can change them.
In that case, we can't move.
No, we can't move anything inside to another file.
Yes.
So it's not something we can do.
Then the
because the checksums are signed, and if you change
so we need to
just a character inside, the
yes.
signature will
yes.
won't match.
So we need to change the arm index pages and move minimum.
No. No, because it isn't the desktop.
Then
the minimal image is a server image, and it has always been server image. Even when we were on fedoraproject.org, Fedora server didn't exist at that time.
But if we can change this file, we can move.
We can change the file. We can change neither the index, but we can add another button if you want. We can group the buttons and say, okay, server checksums, server and minimal, and desktop checksums, workstation and spins.
Mm.
Would that work?
Maybe.
So, go to the verify page.
Oh, yeah. This?
Instead of having server, workstation and spins, we could say, how do I verify my image? Server, two buttons, server and minima. So that's clear. And then desktops, workstation and spins. What's inside is not important. So if I want to verify my minimal image, I would go always to the minimal button. If I want to verify my spins, I will go to the spins button. The file behind it is always the same. I see that as only solution we have.
Mm.
And then we it's also also good to do server custom server server desktop. We can make workstation, spins, and labs.
Yes.
But we will have the other one, which is always under IEC under desktop umbrella. Desktop win.
Well, we don't have labs for our.
We don't have labs for now, but we should have it.
Yes.
Is this desktop computing? We could call it. I'll just call it labs.
These are spins, not labs.
These are spins, but inside we have all the workstation.
Yes, you could say it's a
so
spin,
it's correct to call them spin desktop because they are
yes.
These are desktop environments.
Yes.
Labs are functional.
Yeah, I know.
Images,
but there
so
doesn't
we
seem
could
to be
say
ARM labs.
ARM labs, why not? Yeah.
I don't know if they're available.
They are available. I don't have them on the website because I didn't have the time to make it. Miro already emailed me about that. but anyway, it's something we can work on. You could probably start with you can start with whatever you want for adding the Python classroom image or changing the verify page.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you do the Python classroom image, we need Marie and Masha. because we need an icon.
Oh
we can
yes.
Try to do that, but
I'm
not sure we have something we can work on.
It doesn't have an icon, yes.
Mm.
Yes.
Do you want to work on the icon for Python classroom? Yeah, it's great out. If you go to arm.fedoraproject.org.
So now we can proceed. Work on the ticket, take a charge of the ticket if you want to work on them.
Mm-hmm.
And most importantly, is a git pull command in the Fedora website directory. Do you send a command? Git pull in Fedora directory to update the repository before work on the repo. Okay. It's okay. Git pull on the repo. You have copy and paste the directory before.
Yes.
So is. Update repo. So to update the repo before work on all the
tickets,
you must send a git pull command on the terminal.
Git pull is it git pull dash?
No, git pull. Git pull in the Fedora website directory.
It's just to see.
Do you use Git?
Yeah.
Okay.
It works.
Yes.
Otherwise, you have to change the. Yeah, pulling is okay. Yes.
Okay. And to work on the source code of our pages, you can open directory with the use IDE, do you prefer? So we use Sublime Text or Vim.
Vim is okay.
Okay, Vim.
What is Sublime Text? Because I don't know this.
So
no, you can work on whatever editor you want.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Just try to use an editor which doesn't add trailing spaces or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have, I'm using Sublime Text too, because it has an option to cut to delete all white spaces. So this is something we should avoid. Did you find a ticket or are you?
No, not yet.
Not yet.
Okay.
So
we can, if you want, we could work all on the same, or if you want to choose another one, we can do that too, as you prefer.
Okay.
Another easy one is the first one here, 708. This is 707 is already done. We maintain fedoracommunity.org.
You can use that if you want.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. You stick it for the community in LATAM?
Yeah.
Yes, it's not a Fedora project. So
so we have a report that Proyecto Fedora is not working anymore. LATAM has had there are more than a pull request, but both are not right, totally right. They added something. And this is probably okay from CGIS, but if you want to work on that, we can do that too. I can cancel the pull request and see if we understand. Now, Proyecto Fedora in LATAM is used for several countries. They have subdirectories. For Panama, Chile, and so on. It's just Proyecto Fedora has been transferred in the past to another admin, which disappeared, and nobody cared about this, the main domain, and the content just has been abandoned, or I don't know. So we should just drop it. Others are probably yeah, there's another ticket for ARM, which is 600. Another interesting is this one. like that for KDE, and we could eventually use that using a short name, name and the strict description, and then just explode it in the HTML pages. It's not really an easy fix, but yeah. So if you want, we can work on this. Rafa, do you want to try this one?
No, I don't feel comfortable with the idea to delete somebody's work and redo it. So
no, do you mean the pull request from
yes,
CGIS?
Yes, the pull request.
The pull request has is not complete. So
okay.
It's okay, it's working, but
mm-hmm.
it's not enough.
Mm-hmm.
And the
okay.
other pull request from Luis Bazan is just wrong. So
mm-hmm. okay.
there's nothing to
okay, so
to care about. So we have it here in the main Latin America has Proyecto Fedora in the main section. And then it's also proyectofedora.org Argentina, Mexico. This is another one, Projeto Fedora. And they use it for Panama, for Peru, and Colombia. And the main also for Latin America. If you go to that website, it looks like that. It works. That's Fedora project. Yeah, that's not. They talk about meals and steakhouse. So I think it's not really Fedora. Although I like that. Only cow steak. But it's not something we can keep on the. On the Fedora community the website. So where do you find this file? It's in are you looking at it?
I'm looking for it. I don't know where it is.
It's in Fedora websites, fedoracommunity.org.
Mm-hmm.
Then all the HTML files are in data.
Yeah. And we're next.
This is not a template, but it's a content.
Okay.
And it's part of LATAM.
Oh yeah.
So Fedora websites report that.
Yes.
Oh. Are you CGIS?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Did you
you already something?
Yes. I added the verify dot new.
Okay.
It needs to be a page.
Yes.
So, oh, and I also unified the border because previously it said here, validate.
Yeah, it's okay.
What's wrong with this request? It removes.
It's
just removes those bugs that
it doesn't say validate here, but it says verify everywhere else.
So as far as I understand, you don't want this.
It's how to verify your image, but you use inspire to validate.
I don't know since I
you, well,
you want to verify it.
I think the wording should be the same earlier. Nice verify.
We use
verify
on all the websites.
I suppose that
I've seen verify
the strings.
It says
dot.
It says verify.
But
yeah,
it's just the removing access
Here
model. There's nothing new added.
Okay, I'm not sure about that.
Yes.
Minus and everything in red.
But the in things in red, if you verify the.
I need to try to download
code. Source code. With the
we have
okay, that
which provides you with the
cloud some kind of
some images
or light which
takes to
you can create a mistake on the
implementation.
Okay. Robert is a very
I agree because I'm the same.
Ah, okay, perfect. So I suppose
I think it should be more verified.
The pull request is
It's
I'm not sure.
I'm not a native speaker
for
this.
It's something for
my first pull request is not accepted for this edition.
Okay,
if you want to make it like that, we will have
to code, and I don't know the issue on the.
But I would group them.
Yeah, that's it. But I can see this problem here.
That's okay.
You mean this Robert?
Yes, and now
just ask.
Now Robert.
They shouldn't be removed, maybe they should be replacing something. Maybe just remove, I don't know. Yes, but not web developers, so I'd be happy to learn something. C++, Java. Nothing related with
Okay,
websites.
Not web, but
yes, that's it.
From
I'd be happy to learn something
less
more about web development.
I'm
really surprised to see that you use Python because I didn't know that Python is useful for websites.
It's probably a good idea.
Genshi framework
is
Python.
I want to give it a shot.
So
just try
our website.
Please do.
It would help me with the federalizer as well.
Mm-hmm. So I am.
Yeah. Yes.
Python
because I need to use the text, the information about things and such.
Asking to Robert.
Why don't you use to release JSON?
I couldn't find it. Where is it? Can you tell me?
Get fedora.org.
I think
point to it from the federator directly. Or you can go to you can go to static. This one, yes.
Okay.
We have all images inside.
Okay, that's good.
Actually, on Fedora Media Lite.
That's great.
We don't have secondary options. So we don't have substituted images.
Mm-hmm. And then what I also need to know is the descriptions. Which is right now only inside the template. That's what I wanted to bring out.
Yes. Do you know Martin? What is that?
Not really, not personally.
Because he also parses the description.
Yeah, I know he does. I saw the script and it's even fun to do that. Yeah, it's better if it will be separate inside the website sources.
Yes.
There's a pull request, and I'd like to ask what's wrong with this pull request. How can I do it better if you want it to be better than this? Because it just removes.
It removes all.
Mm-hmm.
I remember there is something. No, he's working on another ticket.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
This guy is not here?
No, it is.
Okay, so maybe we'll just search for another ticket.
Yeah. We can merge that if you want. Yeah.
I think there's nothing to change here, unless you can see anything.
No, it should be okay. But on the... Isn't he missing on top the website?
Is this the 712 pull request?
Just made I know what you mean. No, I'm just saying.
Because there is another issue. Yes, this should be okay. There is another one on. let me get that in.
Yeah, but I don't modify the code. The thing is that the code is using the library, and the issue was inside the library, and the library is now fixed.
Ah.
You know, with the old version of the library, there was the issue which was reported.
On EMEA, there is another link not working.
Which one?
That's what I thought. In pull request, on top, there is another one. Let me look here who created that. Sujiniku. That's 713. He says Fedora Moldavia is not Linux community. This page is how to be actor or actress in Japanese language. So you can do this because he added this in maintenance. Yes, in maintenance.
I cannot see it.
Okay. So we ask Robert.
So you should pull.
Can you update the report?
No issues and pull requests.
Ah,
grab pull requests.
I choose this ticket.
Yes.
So this is JSON file. Then we inform that it's generating some. The JSON is missing some parts. So I went through it.
Yes.
And so I just did a quick check and realized that using the new version of that file,
yes,
fixed the problem. So that means that just using the right version of the file will fix the issue, but you need to do non-code changes.
No,
not code changes are required. Just having the right thing that you find to the problem.
Okay. So are labs inside now?
Labs are inside. This is the I try to write some small script and labs are there.
Mm-hmm.
Also if I directly run the
script,
the script.
You won't find the labs. Are the labs already in the JSON file?
Yeah, this is the JSON file.
No, the JSON file on the website. Go to fedora.org, static, you will find it. Because I spoke with Adam about an issue on ALP, because he was not able to find the ALP directory anymore. And that was because of the old version.
Yeah, but
and this was not documented. And Adam, I had to change passwords. I don't know how it's called.
I
JSON.
releases.json.
Yeah, but it's not there. It's not in the static folder.
Oh, it's there.
Releases.json.
Yeah.
It's not there.
Thank you.
it's readable, should be readable. It's in a static directory, yeah. Well, can you try to recreate it? You need to go to.
I can do it on my local machine.
Yes.
Yeah, I can do.
No,
it
no. You can recreate it directly inside the website's repo, and it will go out. Oh, will write it in the right place. You should go in the.
This is the main make file
directory.
So it runs the release JSON try tool,
okay.
And the output is moved to the static directory.
Yeah.
Because it's
yes,
been modified just minutes ago.
Ah, okay.
Maybe he has accepted already.
Mm.
To ask.
Okay.
So I have another question because Robert commanded me to look at this.
Mm-hmm.
There's another similar problem because Moldavian community has disappeared. I mean, their website disappeared. This is a pull request.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's also okay.
Ah,
I'd
okay.
like to ask your opinion or Robert's opinion. Probably, I don't know, is it correct to replace URL with the word in container?
So
yes, I know, but my question is it correct to write in maintenance, or should we just remove it completely?
You know, this error always.
Yeah.
I guess then.
Like under construction, but it's not. It's kind of sad to remove, but if they are not interested. I don't know who is the person who made it, who it is it somebody from Moldata or not? Why does neither the English name nor the native name, because it's, in English it's Moldova, so in the native language is Romanian, and it's, as far as I remember, it's also Moldova. So I have no idea what language it is. It's similar to Polish. They are not interested.
In Moldova languages, the name is Moldavian or
Moldova. Their language is Romanian. They don't have Moldavian language. As far as I know.
What are you looking for?
the pull request which you recommended to me to look at.
The pull request.
Yeah. About
the pull request is okay,
mm-hmm.
but he added in maintenance.
Yeah. So
what
should
it's written like? Wrong, you should just drop it.
Uh-huh. What
and
should
just kick it
inside instead?
Nothing.
Just remove the whole line.
Remove the whole line,
mm-hmm.
and then look at the page if it comes up.
Uh-huh.
And how it is ordered, if it's okay. And then you can try to replace it.
Mm-hmm.
And do it. Yes.
Okay.
I'm going to delete the other one. Yes.
Okay.
We don't want to have pages or it's working or something.
Mm-hmm.
You can always add it.
Mm-hmm.
In a situation in which you are not black or white.
Okay. So Andrea, if you don't mind,
yes.
Will you show me what to do next? Because as far as I understand, I should make a fork, right?
Okay, right. You log in.
Mm-hmm.
Once you have it for you have one day,
this is Fedora account also.
Okay.
We can also change the link file and make another one for local testing.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't care if we have to English lesson or the one or not.
Okay.
I'm working on
perfect. Okay. So, okay. And we. Yeah.
Maybe you would like.
Okay. Okay.
This isn't my time.
We'll not understand.
Okay.
So, to create the pull request,
mm-hmm.
okay, you comment on your fork. Okay.
But first, I must pull it.
You before you must clone the format. So the same mode
sometimes
okay. You
can just
create another for example my home the website is the master repository. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But my fork of Fedora website in the directory /development/Fedora. So you can master.
He told me and
this one. I should move to another directory, right?
This is the master.
Yes.
Okay. So you can change. You can create and make a deal. Okay.
Perfect.
Okay. What you want?
You need me?
Or for work?
No,
there
is just a mix of spaces and that.
Okay.
Okay.
In the template,
you can
comment
copy
that.
Copy R.
I think someone needs to go and replace all of that spaces at some point. Yes,
okay.
Python suggests spaces, so we should
do it. Yes, in the master.
But not both. Even inside the HTML file, there's spaces, then that, and then spaces.
Right here. Yeah.
No.
No.
That should not be like that.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Perfect.
And now what? But,
Oh, perfect.
Okay. Now, this is the
Python is easy because it won't
your
finish.
Fork.
No.
Repository.
Okay.
Okay.
It will.
Yes.
A copy of master.
You can make spaces and tabs.
It says it's master. I have copy.
Ah, yeah.
But that haven't changed.
But if you do a check before,
before
it tells you change. No.
Take a look. The green things
we have
is that.
Almost all our template of files. That's what.
And this is the same block of code, and it doesn't have spaces, and this one does. Oh.
There are people who.
During some quiet time, just do a big modifying and replace.
I normally use tabs.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Tabs has two spaces. Four.
Yeah, the files, well, it depends on your settings.
Okay.
I have settings for four.
Mm-hmm. Four, right.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we shouldn't use tabs.
Not working.
Okay.
Actually, this is a British keyboard.
Ah, okay.
My very old show. I'm not an expert in Git. We ask.
I'm an expert in Git.
Okay.
Oh,
maybe.
I'm an
help us.
Git. Git command to show remote.
Git remote show origin.
Git remote show, no Git show remote.
Or
no, Git remote show.
Or dash V, it should work too. Git remote dash V.
Remote?
Dash V.
That will
show
so
remote. Yes.
Ah, minus is dash.
Yes.
Yeah,
no.
Ah, okay. Thanks. Okay. So the origin is the master.
Same.
You can change this.
Possible to change the origin, right?
Yes, no,
okay. I didn't know.
Sorry, my workaround to.
I don't know, I've checked the permission.
To don't clone, please don't work. You must change this in this. Change this string,
but
wait to this.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Do you know how?
Sorry?
Do you know how to do it?
See, for me it's very difficult to do the Git. Sorry, Git master.
We need Git experts.
Hello, sorry, I speak Italian.
Okay.
Per non clonare il fork e fare più fretta, gli ho fatto copiare la cartella che aveva del master repository. Però ovviamente Git show remote linka il master, non il fork. Quindi lui dovrebbe cambiare il fork remote, okay, nel suo fork link del Git.
No, he has. You need to add the remote. Git add the remote.
Add it.
Yeah, you have your fork.
Mm-hmm.
You cloned
yes.
your fork,
yes.
which is the origin.
Mm-hmm.
But you need to add also the remote. If
mm-hmm.
we change the main repository, mm-hmm. you need first to update your fork on your computer.
Mm-hmm.
Git pull remote. Git pull remote. You have
two
repos. The main website repo
mm-hmm.
and your fork.
Yes.
And this is your machine.
Mm-hmm.
You need to pull it from the main website repo to your machine
mm-hmm.
and then push it out to your fork.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can file a pull request from your fork, from your fork to the.
So we did the other way.
You need
because
to, you
because
if you go to the
fork
git
here,
git config, you will see that. You will see only a region. You need I git add remote and add the.
Oh, I should I
the main one? Yes.
Put this one?
Yes.
Like this?
Okay.
Enter.
Enter, yeah.
No, definitely not add.
Okay,
can add
I
is adding files.
Hmm? For the YAML file.
Git remote.
Actually, I have to change the strings like this.
Mm-hmm.
The data is here,
mm-hmm.
and this is the code that was copied previously,
mm-hmm.
but it's now just
yeah.
lost there. So now if I'm going to put this into a
file,
the
name is missing.
And it will
what
be
the name?
Remote master,
no?
Yeah, it's it's this one. I would like to show you the thing as well.
Ah, okay, no, it is
just a second.
It's my ticket, so
git remote add upstream.
Maybe downstream.
This one. That. No, you need to underneath the main websites repo, which is upstream.
But I have my main repo already, and it's called origin in my case.
It's fine.
No,
you don't need
your
to
fork is origin.
No, if he cloned it from the. The
mm-hmm.
old URL from the official one, then origin
yes.
is going to be the official one. But it doesn't.
This
is what happened
yeah,
here.
But he forked it right now, right?
Yes, but
you
that
forked it,
yes,
and
but
then
it doesn't,
but
that
it
doesn't
it.
Change the local git remote.
That's it. Yeah.
You can add your own. You can do git remote add, for example, your name
mm-hmm.
and the URL.
So maybe
mm-hmm.
any label, okay?
Yeah,
yes.
You can call it how you want.
Downstream fork. Copy
or for
work.
I usually call it after my name, so I
uh-huh.
git remote add Sankey and the URL,
okay.
and then I push to Sankey.
Yes, you just have to remember when you pull and push
uh-huh,
which
uh-huh.
one
you're
using.
Anyway, would you like to take a look at it?
Yes.
So I have done this. This bit of code, it describes these things,
mm-hmm.
and this is just a loop. Here is the loop. Spinning things.
Yes.
So what was previously copied like 10 times is just once there now.
Yeah.
And it grabs the data from here. Very structured. So you can see I've added those two spins now and it just generates this.
Mm-hmm.
But the advantage is you don't have to take this and copy it for every spin.
Do we have different blocks for mobile
no.
desktop?
No, it's all the same.
All the same.
Yeah, it's done with Bootstrap. It's done with Bootstrap, so it.
Yeah, but sometimes we have two different blocks to make that easier.
So next, I will split this into another file, so it's not in the middle of this one.
Yeah, as a template.
Yes.
Okay.
And
you can then just use the company.
Yes, I can either use Python or I can use YAML like as I just did over here. I would sort of prefer this because you don't need the quotes there. And then.
Mm-hmm.
But it might add a dependency. Which is fine by me. Well,
yeah.
You can see before I finish it, and then you can decide. You can always change it just to Python. But this will be easier to parse in like other languages too. Which is Python.
Because you use another language?
I would use YAML. You know what YAML is?
Yes.
It's like JSON,
yeah.
Except even easier to read.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of this, I would just have loaded the YAML file.
Mm-hmm.
So this is just a proof.
Yes, otherwise you can just include it, not py2, or not xe2.
Yeah, maybe. I've never done that. I don't know Genji.
No, Python.
Okay.
But yeah, let's see, even with YAML, it's okay.
Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect, I will do that then.
The easier, the better.
Yes, this is, I think, very easy to edit.
Yes.
That's the point.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
If it works, we can use it. Next?
Yeah, exactly. I will do that next. And then I will be happy because I can use the same file.
Yeah, actually, we used that on the old Spins website.
I don't know.
It was rather complicated because it was all written in Python and.
Oh.
Yeah.
So no template.
Hmm?
So no template.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's bad. Yeah.
That was too tricky.
Yes, but this is just a very simple for.
Yes. Yes.
I think it's good.
Mm-hmm.
I need to test if it works with localization.
Yeah.
Probably not.
Well, if it doesn't, then I need to fix it so it does.
Although, yeah, if you put that in templates.
Okay, it works.
Yeah, it works, but it will work, sure.
Yeah.
But does it extract the string?
I think it does, because I tried with extract.
Yes.
If you create a pot, the POT file.
How do you do that?
Make POT.
Okay, I'll try to change this text.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I think I can make POT.
And now I check this one.
And now you can
Okay, it's on the your forehand.
Yes, the first look on me.
Yes, right.
When he
knocks,
you
okay.
I should take exactly if it works. So I should do make test. Okay, not here.
Yeah, it seemed to
help. Yeah, before.
So,
okay, perfect.
Maybe Moldavian communication
yeah,
will be redirected to Romanian, but it's okay for yeah, because this takes Romanian language.
Because this won't work with the YAML.
Yeah.
I wonder if it's possible to write a little bit of code.
This
to
work.
Okay.
I don't think that works. To parse it and add it to the.
Okay.
For the translation, the one which generates the top stuff.
Mm.
updated about the
Watch
the core.
Okay.
At least the main is not so. They're a local problem, temporary, hopefully. Beautiful, because actually it's a clone of Fedora magazine. Yeah. If you open Fedora community and search for EMEA, Europe, Middle East, we clicked every link and to make sure that every link works. And every link works except Romania.
Mm.
When you click Romania, you get 502 bug gateway. So the question is what to do about it.
I would say we should just drop it. It's a while we don't check the domains there, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Has been a while.
Who is command on the web? For
who is?
Discover
the admin? Yeah, who is and the domain.
Ah.
But
No.
It's not
Ah, okay.
Do you know any other way to keep it?
There's no admin inside, so it's
privacy.
No, it's
mm-hmm. I wonder if there's anybody from Romania here.
No,
nobody.
So
maybe you should ask Zibek because she was in Romania for holidays just a week ago. Maybe he knows somebody.
Really?
Mm. Jean-Baptiste. He's around here.
Yeah.
Not here in this
I
room, but around.
We can always re-add it, committing it.
So it's okay to delete?
Yes.
Okay, so
I
will delete.
Just
should we make a new pull request or can we do it in the same pull request?
For me it's in the same pull request.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just make one.
Okay. Not create another ticket only Romania.
Okay.
No. We use the ticket for Moldavia to drop
it.
It's possible,
okay.
But first we would need to write a new extraction method for Babel.
Just in time. Okay. So
an extraction method, we should open the YAML file and
you
take the strings that we need to do. I can do it, but I would do it as a second thing. First, I would rewrite the stuff like this. Make a pull request with that.
Do we need to actually put them to
No, it would be just the same.
It's a shame just adding the stuff to
the
Short because I think it should be some longer description because like here is the title. No, I think it should be different. Maybe we should
Robert?
Hmm? Can you please come?
Yes.
Yeah. Trying to make a nice commit comment because we have made
because there isn't a ticket, but it's only the...
This is the ticket.
Remove Moldavian and the website.
But should we refer to this request?
No.
No?
No.
Okay. So...
No. You can just write remove Moldavian and Romanian.
For me, it's okay to open the editor in the uppercase to move.
Moldavian and.
Oh, whatever.
Just identify what.
Yes, but I'm afraid that it is too short. It should be longer.
No? No. It didn't talk so much. Just dropping it.
Community website.
Okay. So, how to contribute to Fedora website team? You can join our mailing list. Okay. With a send self introduction.
Fast account do you have already?
Yeah.
Okay. A request to join the website group. You can follow us on the Freenode IRC channel and on the Fedora mailing list website team. Okay. Question? Parameterized pins like that. Do you? Is this okay?
Yeah.
The name of the branch.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Okay.
Okay.
So we have 5 minutes left.
Does it know that it's me who makes the push?
But you are registered in Purdue, right? Yes.
Okay, but this is a command line git. How does this command
from the config?
Config. So maybe I did the config incorrectly. Okay.
Now it's in config files.
Where is the config file?
It's in git. Do you have file manager?
Yeah. What do you use? This one?
This one? Yeah, okay.
I hate that code. Yeah, I usually prefer the command line.
Home?
Okay.
I don't remember the...
Maybe
can sorry. You show the... just go to...
Maybe I have put incorrect email address, maybe I should use a different one because I don't know if...
yeah, probably. Do you have this email address?
Yes, but I don't know if Pagur knows about it. Mm-hmm. If Pagur knows another email address.
How did you register Pagur?
I didn't, it's just a copy of Fedora. Fast.
Yes,
but maybe FAST prefers my address at federalproject.org.
Yeah.